Alright, so there's clearly $8 in here. I don't know if that happens first or second, but it's definitely getting bigger or smaller. AMD on the ZIP. I'm going to use, if you watch the video for another mile where I messed it up, I'm doing this in Corel right now, so we'll see if I can do it correctly the first time. I'm going to highlight these points so I can tell what ends up where. So A should end up at Z, which is over here. M should end up at R. And D should end up at D. So you can see that the yellow and the blue ones are reversed. So I should reflect it over the y-axis. And doing this kind of tells me which way to reflect it. If say the green and the yellow were upside down, then I want to reflect it over the x-axis. This is challenging to do. Which is why I actually just started doing this highlighting thing through watching this year. I didn't do it before. So let's reflect it over the yellow line. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, this. Not there. Don't shoot it in the jumps like that. 1, 2, 3. D is going to end up here. Z A is going to end up 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Alright, so then this is A. And this is M prime, and this is G prime. So then my hope is that as we highlight these, so that's green, that's blue, that's yellow. So my hope is that if I do a dilation now, it'll line me up nice and easy. So A has to go to Z, so let's put my points down. A prime is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And Z is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2. Okay, and if you had a variation, it should be a simple one. That's clearly getting multiplied by 2. So we have a reflection over the y-axis followed by a variation of 2. So that's all for this unit. I'm going to have some more of these specific problems in a file because these are some of the harder ones that will be included later in the unit. And if you get yourself through everything and you need some extra practice on some stuff, you absolutely have a chance to practice these things.